टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सॉक्रेट, है ना, द फिलोसफी ऑफ सॉक्रेट्स. व्हाट इज द फिलोसफी ऑफ सॉक्रेट एंड व्हाट वाज हिज ओपिनियन अबाउट द एजुकेशन. एंड वी विल टॉक अबाउट द फिलोसफिकल थॉट ऑफ अ सॉक्रेट एज अ होल, बिकॉज व्हेन यू विल सी द लाइफ ऑफ अ सॉक्रेट, ही वॉज नॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ फिलोसफर हु वॉज वर्किंग फॉर मनी एंड ही वॉज नॉट टीचिंग फॉर मनी. ही इज सेड टू बी द स्ट्रीट फिलोसफर एंड दैट्स वाई ऑलमोस्ट देर इज नो लिटररी एविडेंस अवेलेबल अबाउट हिज वर्क, हिज थॉट, हिज फिलोसफी. ऑलमोस्ट नो वर्क इज अवेलेबल इन द रिटन फॉर्म एंड दैट्स वाई वेन यू विल सी द सॉक्रेट यू विल फाइंड दैट वेरी लिटिल नॉलेज इज अवेलेबल टू द वर्ल्ड. हाउएवर वॉट एवर द नॉलेज वी नो अबाउट द सॉक्रेट इज बाई द राइटिंग बाई समवन एल्स. सपोज दैट यू आर राइटिंग अबाउट द समवन, सो थ्रू दैट राइटिंग द लाइफ, द वर्क, the thought, the philosophy of Socrates is known to the world. And that is obviously it is not an original work. Because when I am writing about the someone's other work or something others when I am writing, obviously my interpretation, my way of thinking, my way of looking on that comes. When you will explain your own idea and when I will explain your own idea, there will be a difference. When you will be explaining, your thought, your philosophical ideas and orientation will be reflected in the true sense. But when I will be explaining, then the philosophical thought and orientation to be mixed with my way of thinking will come. And that is the problem with the when we try to study about the Socrates. It is always a problematic to understand the Socrates. And I have told you previously also that when we try to understand the philosophy of some philosopher, isn't it, then we must understand the life of the philosopher, because it is the life, it is the situation, it is a condition which molds their thought process. That molds their thought process, isn't it? So, but in this case, when we talk about the Socrates, the problem is that the childhood life, the family background, the situation in which he has grown up, it is unknown to the world. Or very little knowledge is available. Very little knowledge in the sense of linking his thought, linking his way of life to the context is available, isn't it? So that is the another difficulty with the Socrates. However, it is believed that Socrates took birth in the 469 BC and died at the age of 70 year in 399 BC. So his life was between 469 BC to 399 BC. And he is acclaimed as the father of Western philosophy. He was the first who have started philosophizing his ideas, the thought. He was the first person. And he was also the teacher of the great philosophers of that time. The Plato, that whose educational ideas and the philosophy we have already studied, Plato was the student of Socrates, isn't it? And who the Plato was mentioning the philosophical ideas, thought, the teaching of the Socrates in his many work. And through those work, we are knowing about the Socrates. I told that the Socrates was not a philosopher who was working for a money. He said to be the street philosopher. He had no written literature available of his work. So whatever the knowledge we have about the Socrates is through the work of the others. And the many work is of his student. And among the all the student, Plato was one who frequently mentions the work, thought and the philosophy of Socrates. So from those work, we understand the philosophical orientation, philosophical thought and other thing about the Socrates. Socrates was, I told that he was not teaching for the remuneration. He was not teaching for the money. And his work, his thought is known by the work of his student. And he had not left no literary legacy behind him. So there is nothing available about the Socrates. But how almost there is a no literature, no knowledge about the Socrates during his childhood or of his earlier life. There is nothing available. However, by seeing the traits of his learning, thought and other thing, it is believed that he have been schooled in the Athens, because the Athensian system of education already we have discussed. So those traits are seen in his thought, in his learning and others. So that's why it is believed that Socrates was schooled in the Athens. And since he was person from the Greece and he went for schooling to the Athens, so it is believed that he is from the aristocrat family or at least a middle class family. Because if it is from the lower strata of the society, he could not travel and could not go to the Athens for the education. And that's why it is believed that at least he is from the middle class family. However, there is no literature available. And after that, until the age of 18 years, he entered in the military service. And after that, Socrates worked from time to time as a stone cutter and also as a sculptor. And he had worked for two famous sculptures, that is one the Hermes, the god, and another one is the Three Graces. These are the two famous sculptures of the Socrates, isn't it? And later on, he devoted the full time of his life to investigating and practicing the philosophical dialogue. So that was the life of the Plato. Even when he started practicing and investigating the philosophical dialogue, he got some of his follower. Follower means his student. He got some of his student. And when he was teaching those students, he had been alleged that he is the parent of the student. They have alleged that he is influencing the mind of their children. Their children means the student of the Socrates. He is influencing the mind of the children. And because of his earlier association with the opponents and the opponents of the democratic regime, he was opponent of the democratic regime, and he was also very, which is made, him a very controversial figure because he was an opponent of the democraticism. The parents of his student were opposing him because he was alleged that he is the influencing their mind, means doing a brainwashing of their mind. So this all incident had made him a very controversial figure, and he was also involved in the politics because he was opponent of the democraticism. So he has been charged by that government that he is corrupting the youth people and interfering with the religion of the city. So he has been charged, and because of this charge, Socrates was sentenced to death in the 399. That was at the age of 70 years. He was a very controversial figure of the Greece because of his philosophical idea, which was not well suited with that time. So in the 399 BC, he was sentenced to the death, and he was the person who have very happily accepted the outcome of the all these procedures. And at the age of 70 years, he take the hemlock, which is a kind of a poison, and he died. And the whole thing like that, the trial which was happening in that time of court, like that in the now also in the court, we have a trial if someone will alleged you. So he was alleged that he is interfering in the religion, in the politics, and he is playing with the mind of a youth. So he has been alleged. So the trial was going on. So the process of a trial, the last day of the Socrates, isn't it? And his dialogue, it is written, penned by the Plato. He, because the Plato was the student of the Socrates, and he has come up with the three writings, the Apology, the Crito, and the Phaedo. So these are the three writings in which the Plato has penned down the incident of the trials, incident of the last time life of the Socrates, isn't it? So this was about the life of a Socrates. Now we will see about the educational thought of the Socrates. When we talk about the educational thought of a Socrates, in the ancient Greece, Socrates argued that he was in the opinion that education is about drawing out what is already within the student, within the child. So education is a process by which we are drawing out what is already in the student. And even the modern notion of the education, modern definition of the education, when we see that, we all know that education is derived from a Greek word educare, which means to lead out. So the point of saying that, you can easily understand the concept of education conceptualized by the Socrates is how much relevant now and how is accurate to the point of the modern notion of the education. Because in the modern time also, we believe that student, the child, have all the potential within the self. Like that, when we talk about the constructivism, even we understand, we assume that student have all the potential, only we have to nurture those potential by providing the suitable environment. And the understanding, the definition of the education by the Plato was also that to draw out what is already within the student. So in that sense, you can understand that how the Socratic conception about education is relevant in the today time and it is accurate. Then when we talk about the education, the main contribution of the education in the education by the Socrates is the Socratic method. Socratic method, I have told you that while when I was teaching about the Plato, that in the Plato teaching method is the Socratic method, and I have told you that it is a dialectic method, wherein it is a dialectic method where in the teaching happens through the questioning. And before that, I will also tell that it is a dialectic method, and it is named as a Socratic method after the Socratic philosopher's name. So in the by the name of a Socratic, this method is named after his name as a Socratic method. And here in this method, questions are posed by the teacher. Questions are posed by the teacher to get the student to think about what they already have, because the Socrates was in opinion that a student already have all the things in their mind. It is only we have to draw out what is already existing. We have to nurture, we have to brush up that. So here the teaching was through the problem, through the question posing, which was giving the student opportunity of a thinking what they already know and to realize that what they don't know. So that when the question, when the problem will be posed, they will be start thinking about that, and they will come to know that what they have about the problem, about the question, and what they don't know about the question, how to solve it. And this question and answer session stimulates their student's brain, their mind, in engaging them in bringing out the new knowledge, new ideas, creative thinking, critical thinking, and it is a process of brainstorming. By this, the brainstorming will be happening, because here the teacher is posing the question, they are supplying the questions, they are supplying the condition, and they are allowing a student to think in a diverse way. So the student will be coming with the answer, with the solution, by engaging their mind, by using their mental faculty. So it will lead to the constructive, creative, and critical thinking. And they will also realize, they will be able to reflect that to which extent what they know and to which extent what they don't know. Isn't it? So that was the Socratic method, and this was the one of the prime contribution of Socrates to the field of education. And the other things are derived from the Socratic methods. Like that, when we talk about the Socratic dialectical method, so it was a distinct from the other method of a teaching at that time. Other method of a teaching at that time was the dialogue method, and the lecturing method. This was the method of teaching at that time, but this was a unique method because it was able to inculcate the ethics of knowledge. The ethics of knowledge means the linking the knowledge to the happiness, linking the knowledge to the prosperity. This was an attitude which influenced the latter Greek philosophers also. Because here, how it was a ethics of knowledge, because here the student were able to realize that what they have and what they don't have, and what they don't have, how to proceed for gathering those knowledge, how to proceed for solving the problems. This Socratic method was also opposing view, that is, the better society must maintain the punishments. This is because that when we talk about the Socratic methods, it also inculcating the value that if you don't know the answer, if you don't have a logic, then how you can proceed for fetching the knowledge and solving the problem, isn't it? So in that way, it was the unique in nature. Even when we talk about the Socrates, so Socrates was also talking about the merits and the demerits, and he was in opinion that Socratic ethics of knowledge has a merit and a demerit. The merit is that it is a free of possible misconception in terms of tradition and theology, because the possibility of misconception is minimized here. How it is minimized? Because the students are coming with the reason, the logic and the solution of the problem based upon their own experiences and based upon their thought process. So the logic and the answer and the solution is generated out of the thought of the child. So the point of misconception can be minimized here, isn't it? So even the rationalism was also promoted by the Socrates through his dialectical method, because Socrates believed that the man is capable of arriving at truth through the use of a reason. And he criticized that anyone who used to convince a people is a wrong, is a not a logical, it is a not a rational. Because the rational should come with a reason, and the person is capable of coming at a reason. So that's why there is no point of convincing someone. If we are trying to convince, then it is a kind of a malpractice wherein we are trying to impose our thought, our orientation to someone's other person. So in that way, he was against the convincing of people, and he was in a opinion that men are capable of reasoning out everything. So it can, every man can reason the problem. Okay. And when we see about the Socratic philosophy, so he had a different, he has suggested, it is not like that he has suggested, through the writings of the other scholars, other you can mean that the student of a Socrates, it is evident that he has some systemic division of his on philosophy, that is the Socratic philosophy. The first division that is identified from the Socratic philosophy is the philosophical anthropology. And here he talks about that the proper object of a philosophy is a man, the human, better to say that, because when you see the man, it is a gender biased word. So now you can replace the man with the human. He was in opinion that the proper study of a philosophy is the human. Because Socrates was believing that the metaphysical questions are not much important. Isn't it? So he believed that the philosophy should achieve practical result in the form of a greater well-being of a human and the society. Hence, the proper study of a philosophy of a human, that should be the ethical and that should be practiced. Because the humans are the main object of a study as per the philosophy of Socrates concerned. He was not having the much belief on the metaphysical world. He was also in opinion that the natural ethics, that is another kind of Socratic philosophy, was the natural ethics. And here Socrates attempts to establish an ethical system based upon the human reason rather than the theological directives of the priest and the rulers. He was in a belief that the ethics should come from the human reason, from the human point of view, not from the theological point of view that is directed by the priests or the rulers. So from this philosophy, you can understand that by nature, Socrates was not a theist. He was the atheist philosopher, because he was trying to define the ethics from the human reason point of view, not the religious literature point of view. So he was saying that the theological directives are not much important and not the ethical one, rather than the human reason and the perspective from the human is a more important. So you can understand that he was respecting the all the humans alike. And the later on, when you will see about the philosophy of the Socrates, you will find that Socrates was also in opinion that both men and women are equal. Both men and women are equal, and that's why they must be educated equally. Since both men and men are equal, so they must be educated equally. There should be no differences between the men and women, and they must be trained equally. All the training should be equal. The next kind of a philosophy is that the political philosophy of the Socrates. And Socrates was never approved the democracy kind of a thing. He was in opinion that the best form of a governance is what is ruled by an individual possessing a greatest ability, knowledge and the virtue. So he was not in the favor of a democracy. However, some of his ideas were very progressive in nature, like that the treating men and women equally. It was a very progressive in nature. But however, he was not in the favor of a democracy. He was in opinion that the state must be ruled by a government or by an individual possessing a greatest ability, knowledge and a virtue. So by the virtue it should be ruled, not by the other thing it must be ruled, not the opinion of a people should be taken care, like that he was in the opinion, isn't it? So that was the philosophical orientation about the Socrates. Even when now see the educational philosophy of the Socrates. So when we talk about the educational philosophy of a Socrates, Socrates offers a distinct methods of teaching, which is known as the Socratic method of teaching, which was a quality oriented and which was the learner oriented. So the Socratic method, which is the actually a kind of a dialectic method, have some distinct features. The first feature of the Socratic method is it is a problem-centric method. So from that we can also conclude that the educational philosophy of a Socrates was it must be problem-centric. And how this dialectic method was, or a Socratic method was, a problem-centric? Because here the problem is being posed and the learner are supposed to fetch the answer, come with a solution with their own thought process by investigating, by searching, by collaborating, that kind of a thing. So it was a problem-based, problem-centric method. And even in the now, even in the recent pedagogical innovation, we talk about that problem-centric teaching learning practices. So it is still relevant. When we talk about the dialectic method and problem posing, and the student will be working for solution of the problem by applying their critical and creative thinking processes, it is a student, it is the based upon the student experiences, wherein the student or a dialogue participant respond on the basis of their own knowledge and experiences. So it was a student centric also, and it was based upon the critical thinking, because in order to solve a problem, in order to come with a solution, you must apply your creative and critical thinking to come with a solution. It was also acting as a learning by discovery, because a student have to come up with their own solution. Only the teacher will be helping them. And by learning as a discovery, Socrates was believing that it will destroy the illusion that are already comprehended by the world, because they will be experiencing. So it will destroy the illusion. And he was also believing that the honestly accepting the fact of our own ignorance, vital step towards our acquisition of a genuine knowledge. Because here you are not only understanding what is your strength, but here you are also understanding where you lack, what is your the lacuna, that is also realized and are reflected by the students. So which is the vital step toward the acquisition of a genuine knowledge, because you will start working for learning those type of things, isn't it? And as per the Socrates, the purpose of education was the self-education. The education is not a thing which can be transferred by the someone to the someone. And that's why I was saying that he was against the convincing someone, because you cannot convince someone. That is unethical as per the Socrates. So the purpose of education is the self knowledge. The educated man is wise when he knows himself. You are knowing what you know and what you don't know and where you have to work hard. What is the best suited thing for you? That is the good knowledge. And this is the one of the purpose of education as per the Socrates. He was also believing that a purpose of education must be to develop a good moral character. The acquisition of a knowledge is valuable for man because it makes him virtuous and happy. But Socrates also says that the ornamental theory of knowledge is not very worthy. He says that by the education, by the learning, the children must become morally sound. And the next and last purpose of education as per the Socrates was skill in thinking. He was saying that each person must develop his skill in critically appraising the propositions through the reasoning and process. So the critical, the thinking, creative thinking, reasoning, this type of a skill must be developed when we are talking about the education. So that was as per the Plato. Even when we talk about before I was talking about the he was in favor of the women education. And he was saying that both men and women must be educated physically and intellectually. Physically and intellectually, both was emphasized for both men and women. And he was in opinion that we must train the women for the military event. And in the word of Socrates, in an ideal city, men and women will be used for the same purpose. That was the quotation of the Socrates within the quote. That the men and a women will be used for the same purpose. Same purpose when they will be used, then the men and a women must be trained, educated in the same way as the men are being educated. Women must be also educated in the same way. Okay, so that was the opinion of Plato on the women education. Even when we talk about the curriculum as per the Plato, since the main basis of educational thought about the Plato is the dialectic method, that is the Socratic method. This is the main pillar of understanding the educational philosophy of a Socrates. So when we analyze the Socratic method, dialectic method proposed by the Socrates, we believe that it is a process wherein the student will be critically engaged to solve a problem, to reflect on their ability and what they need to know. So when we critically analyze this thing, the subjects, the discipline may be the various kind. It may be either from the social science, it may be from the science, it may be from mathematics, it may be from the astrology. So even it may be from the language. So variety of subjects are suggested when we talk about the curriculum as per the Socratic method, Socratic philosophy of teaching. Even when we talk about the teacher, so as per the Socratic philosophy, teacher is the person who leads the student, because as per the philosophical belief of a Socrates, the education is meant to draw out what is already existing in the children. So how these already existing in the children will be drawn out? By leading the child. So the teacher must be a good leader, who is a torch bearer, who will be guiding the student, leading the student. However, it is not very clear about the discipline and all those kind of a thing about the Socrates, that what kind of a concept of the discipline he was having. Isn't it? That is not very clear, because the Socrates is a kind of a street philosopher who have not written any literature. So that is why it is not very clear. But when we talk about the teacher, teacher is a leader in his concept, who can nurture. And you can see that even the Socrates was alleged that he is influencing the children. So the teacher must be influential person who can inspire, who can influence the student. So that type of concept of a teacher is conceptualized in the philosophy of Socrates.